Hey guys, so I'm calling the Panther diorama finished. I've done a couple of things to it since the last time you saw it. I've finished the figures and stuck them on there, and I did some live camouflage to the Panther itself, and I built a rose bush, which I'm not entirely sold on, at least not at the moment. It was something new I wanted to try, but now that I did it, I know how to do it better. And you know, it's one of those things. So I can probably still improve the rose bush, but not right now, maybe later. So there's two figure sets on here, and they're both dragon sets. One I did a really, really long time ago. It was almost beyond the point of saving, and I probably should have just turfed them. They were in really bad shape, and I painted them originally with enamels, and I used enamels. The thinner I used in the enamels was a bit hot, so it kind of messed with the plastic a bit. So it's softened the detail quite a bit. It's these fellows here in the corner here. And so they're not as great as they could be. I tried to hide most of it with a clever paint job, but they're still a little bleh. But they're serving their purpose, and I ended up using them rather than throwing them in the garbage. So I prefer to do that usually in most cases. So they're done, and they're, you know, I posed them in the scene where they're about to do a breach and clear on the shed. That's the shed that Chalky, Ian White, CW Modeling, donated. This is a collaboration build now between me and him. He built that building. I built that building. The other figure set is also a dragon set, and it's a... I don't remember the name of them. They're a bunch of infantry Viking division in 1944, I believe it is, in Poland, I think it is. So I used them and used the same camouflage scheme that was on these fellas on both figure sets to blend them together so that they look like they're from the same unit. This figure set was a wonderful figure set. It was astonishing. The detail was beautiful, and they went together really well. The faces look really good, and when I was painting them, the detail just popped. So it's a really nice figure set. Probably one of the better ones of dragons that I've built in a long time, so I was quite pleased with it. Almost, I'd say, on par with a resin set. Not quite, but it was close. So I enjoyed them very much. Insofar as I can enjoy figures anyway. Generally, the way figures go is if they're, you know, not the greatest looking figure, like a mini art figure or something like that, I'm not going to enjoy building that much. Some master box figures I don't like that much. Some of them are a little bit reminiscent of mini art. But the newer dragon figures are pretty nice. Some of the Tamiya's newer ones are pretty nice too. But resin figures, usually whenever I work on them, I have no trouble with them. They're actually quite fun to paint, and I hate painting them. So, you know, if I can get away with that, I'm a happy man. So, finishing these guys up, it was a bit trying because my eyes were giving me problems. So I had to take it really slow. So it was at least 8 days, I guess, it took me to do the figures, where normally it would only take me 2 or 3. So it was a pretty slow go, but eventually they're, you know, done. The Panther, I used some of my pomosa fern. I probably could have at least doubled the amount of pomosa that's on the Panther, but it's kind of expensive for me to get, and it's kind of hard for me to get it. So I used it a little sparingly, so there's not as much on there as I probably should have put on there. But it's the first time I ever did anything like that, and I wanted to see, you know, what it looked like and how to attach it and stuff like that. Still working on that. So it was interesting, though. The rose bush, which is that thing there. I can get it in shot there. It's that thing right there in the corner. It's just a piece of lichen that grows around my yard called Old Man's Beard that I painted kind of a dark gray color. At least the rose bushes that I have grown around here, the branches are a dark gray. And the leaves are dark green. So I did that. I gave it dark gray branches and dark green leaves. And then I tried to put roses, red roses on it, but the paint soaked too deeply into the leaf material, and they're not dark enough, or they're not bright red enough. So if I do it again, I'll use unpainted material, so it doesn't do that again, and it remains bright. So, but lesson learned. That's how that works, you know. I'm gonna leave it there though, because I like it. I may end up making more roses and sticking them on there later anyway. So, I mean, it's right there on the edge. It's not like it's hard to reach or anything. And it's just going to sit behind me on the table. So that's that, I guess. There's really not much else to talk about, I guess. I think I described everything else in the previous video. I think I did. Pretty sure I did. So, this is my first video series that was entirely on VidMe. I don't know if I'm going to release this on YouTube or not. You know, I posted all the videos on my Facebook page, so if anyone cared to look at it, there they are. I'll probably post the final, this video anyway, on YouTube. Just so that I have the conclusion in both places. But the rest of the video series is on VidMe. I think that's it. So again, thank you, Ian, for your shed. It's what finished this diorama for me. It completes the story for me anyway. And I appreciate the donation. It was very kind of you. I put together a shortish slideshow. I hope it is anyway. And then I'm going to put this on the shelf and move on to the Russian diorama that I'm working on. And that might take me until Christmas. I don't know. I don't think so. It might. It might not. Anyway, that's all I got. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.